gotcha.
Hello, and it's Stuart again, playing Ghost Recon Wildlands, and you have joined me as I am just doing some side missions. I just thought I would take a minute to give my review in progress. I haven't played through enough of the game to give an official review, but there's no reason I can't discuss the points that I like with you. And there are many. There are many, 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 many points that I like on this game. Oh, just missed him. So, obviously it's kind of dark and dimpsy, if you've got that saying, near where you are, near where you're watching from. It's dark and dimpsy. Come on. There we go. Give myself a bit more cover. So, if I come out of thingy, there you go, you can see it's quite dark. I'm playing on HDR on my TV screen, so it's probably a little bit darker than what you're seeing. But, night vision. So what do I like about this game? Well, I like the freedom. I like the freedom to do things how you want to do things. That is what is good. There we go. You know, you can go in all guns blazing. Obviously, there are some stealthy missions which require a little bit more finesse. But, in general, you can go into this any way you want. Like this guy here, he's just about to go to sleep. Now, if I sneak in and grab him, certain people you can interrogate, others you just have to knock out. There, on the noggin. Yeah. So the freedom. Effectively, you can go into this game and do the missions however you want, really. And it is true. You've got freedom to do missions in the way you want. You can go in methodically taking them all out, or you can just go in and just kind of see how it goes. You know, you can take out a few guys, keep it loud, keep it proud, and what have you. Personally, I prefer the quiet approach because I think you can sneak through and go through there. The areas where you go and do your missions, that's another thing where you've got freedom. So if I take you to the tactical map now, you'll see, obviously, I'm going through the individual areas. I've only completed three areas, but, you know, I've got a good idea of what the game is like. But I'm now going through methodically, kind of trying to clear all of these little question marks to find all the locations, all of the side missions, all of the weapon parts, all of the skill points and things like that. And that's the kind of thing that I'm doing at the moment. But, you know, if I wanted to, I could go down into this area. We've got a story mission there. Locate Ramon Feliz. And effectively, I could go down and just take this guy out. Alternatively, I could just walk across into this area and it would start the missions in that area. So there is a lot of freedom with that. Does that mean Mr. Feliz is... There you are, see? Mr. Feliz. We can go and take out the underboss now, you see, if I wanted to. I'm not going to just yet, because I don't want to just yet. I want to take out... You know, I want to get my character up to skills. And that brings us on to the skill tree. So, I like skill trees. I think they're really good because you get to specialize your character in certain areas on the thing. So you've got weapons, which is self-explanatory. Time to aim, you know, which is basically like aim down sights. You've got your drone stuff, so you can increase speed and its battery, its range, how good it is at marking the area. That is a fantastic one. I recommend that you go through that one. You just have to go through that one. That's my opinion. Items, you can get more frag grenades, you know, you get more for that. C4, thermal vision comes in handy. It does come in handy. I don't use it a massive amount, But I think I might do it in a few missions just to see. And then you've got flashbangs to blind people, so you can run in and then, you know, take them out. Flare guns, which is, you know, used to make it attract people there. And they all aim up to these epic skills, which means basically you have to have all of the first item in all of the previous ones, which is good. I like it because there's no easy way of doing things. So then you've got those ones, stamina, or those kind of physical ones where you can run longer, more resistance to bullets, you know. You know, detection, you can help. You can use car shields, which basically effectively means that, you know, when you're driving vehicles, they take less damage. And things like that. But the one I want is this one here. Extra sync shot. Now, if you're playing on your own, that is an invaluable thing. Essentially, when you're playing on your own, you've got four people in your squad, and each one of them has a gun, obviously. So, what we can do is, so we've got sync shot. So, see this guy here? We can sync him. Just say the word. We'll sink that guy. I've got the target. Let's try and find some people around here. I'm trying to free these rebels. They're going to be inside, aren't they? Because it is dark, you know.
Here's target number five.
There's a guy there. Come on, where are you?
Marking a captain.
But essentially. So now those two have got their marks, you see. So what we can do now is we can tell them to shoot at him, basically. Take the shot.
Taking a shot. Nice bad guy.
There we go. So you can use your AI teammates. The AI wasn't fantastic on the beta, I won't lie to you. I wasn't a fan. I generally have only played this game with friends, which is, in my opinion, the best way to play it. But if you want to play the game and you've got no friends that are online and this is your only option, then you have to make the best of the situation. And there he is. Mark him. Right. So now we've got everybody marked. First guy to take out is that guy in that building over there. Unless I can get an epic shot on this guy over here, which I should be able to. It's only 150 meters away. Oh, he moved. Right, okay. Let's move in. And now I'm going to tell my teammate to fire.
Ready? Open fire.
Just go for it now. That's what I'm telling them. I don't care about the lieutenant.
They're coming right for us.
There we go. The lieutenant's down. But your AI, you know, use them. Get them to cover you.
Fucking hell.
Ooh, there's a red car just gone zooming off. There you go. We have got one more bad guy, but
clear.
I think he's
how you guys holding up?
Miles away. Yeah. Get them to sync their shots. Get them to take them out. You know, use your teammates to do what they can do. And they are pretty good at taking down people. So good. Okay. Right, we need to get out of here because the proverbial guano is going to go down. Tag supplies, invaluable. So, freedom of the game, that's the one thing that I like, I think, more than anything.
They're on alert.
Is just the ability to do whatever the hell you want to do. At any time, really. You know, it's just such a good way to do things. Which car do I want? You know, it's such a good way to do things. It means that at no point do you feel like you're being... Well, so far, I at no point have felt like I've been forced to go down one particular route. With the ability to... with the ability to pick your own missions and things like that, you literally are given free rein of what you can do. And that's something that, you know, nutshot is brilliant, really, in my opinion. I think that there's too much can be said for linearity, and this gives you a good balance between the two, which is a good thing. So let me find where I'm going to head to now. I'm going to head over here to this helicopter, I think, because I like helicopters.
Hang on, I'll drive.
So your AI are pretty good. You know, playing with teammates, always be strong to what you're good at. If you're good at the tactical side and the stealthy side of the game, and, you know, stick to that. Don't try, if you're no good at stealthy stuff and you're too impatient or whatever, just don't try and be stealthy if you're not that kind of gamer, because you'll get caught out, you'll get killed and what have you. And it's just, especially if you've got to do stealth missions, it becomes frustrating if, you know, if you're no good at them. If you're playing with friends, and I've had an experience recently playing with a friend of mine where, you know, he's not very good at being stealthy. So we had a stealth mission and he let me go and do the mission. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, you stick to what you're good at and you just run with that, you know. So graphics wise, in my opinion, this game looks fantastic. You know, it does. It looks really good. It looks sharp. It looks colourful. You know, it's a very, very nice looking game, in my opinion. We're going to go off and do this one now. It doesn't matter if they don't get on, because they spawn on you.
Let's roll.
Flying and the driving is questionable, as you can see. It could just be me. There could be other people that are absolutely fine with it. But in general, the game is brilliant. You can't go wrong, really. I mean, if you like these kinds of games, my worry for the game was that as you move up in levels, the characters that you're fighting against would be stronger. But it doesn't seem that that is the case. Generally, a well-placed sniper bullet to the square and the chops will kill them, which is what you would expect to happen. You wouldn't expect them to start taking bullets to the face. You know, that's not something that you would expect, right? I'm going to land this here. We're suspected, but that's fine because they're all inside. This is a good little one, this one. Basically, you have to blow up shit.
Frag out.
Tango's just got a wake up call.
Target down.
is running people. Let's go already.
I have no idea why my team aren't firing.
Frag out. Get some. History.
Someone hacked the network. Right, mission failed. That's fine. Stupid mission. I hate these ones. But anyway. But the fact is, you know, I failed the mission. It doesn't send you back anywhere. You just have to come back at a later time. So far. I like the freedom. I like the ability to do whatever you want to do. What don't I like? The driving. The driving is a bit, you know, driving and flying is a bit dodgy, but I can look past those because the rest of the game, I think, is fantastic. I've thoroughly enjoyed the time I've played on this game so far, which has only been about 7 hours, but, you know, it's 7 hours well spent. And that's what I like about this kind of game, is that you feel like you're doing something all the time. I've never once thought, as I come in for a ridiculously heavy landing. The helicopter did not like that. That helicopter is smoking. You know, you never feel like at any point you're struggling of things to do.
We got tangos, danger close.
You know, there's always something to do, whether it's clearing up the areas that I'm like I'm doing now, or what really? There's always something to do. Just gonna look around these buildings. Your drone is just priceless. There we go. They're all in there. They're all in the buildings. You know, get your drone's battery life up. You can spot for longer. That's what you need to do, really, for this game. You need to get your drone up. Your drone is invaluable. It really is. And as we come into this bit here, they're both going to sleep. They are. It should be nice and easy then.
Down. They're going to see.
Okay, cleared that one out there. That's some green stuff. Tag supplies. Where are they? Out there.
We're cool.
The game is just great. So I'm going to leave it there whilst I'm taking these guys out. You know, if you like this kind of game, the nice tactical shooters, then you're not going to be disappointed.
Hostile down.
You know, you're definitely not going to be disappointed. The game itself is vast. I mean, look at the map. The map is huge. You know, you've got all of these areas up here, so I'm sure there'll be people who will want to 100% it. I may or may not. Depends how I go. But pick it up. Have a go. If you've got a friend that's got the game, have a loan. You know, it's just good. It's just, I keep coming back. It's pretty simplistic. I just enjoy this kind of game. You know,
all clear, all clear.
cleared an area, found another area nearby. I'm just going to run there. Because quite frankly, it's only 500 metres away. So, you know, I want to run there. So you can. You can go by car, go by boat. But not everywhere by boat, obviously. But just have a... it's just a fun game where you can decide what you're going to do. I don't think there's enough of that these days. You know, there's definitely not enough of those kind of games out at the moment. Unknown location. There we go. So this is the ranch. I'm going to give this a miss, maybe. But we'll see. But anyway, you've been watching Thumb Culture. You've just been watching a little bit of a review in progress. There'll be some more reviews like this coming up. But for now, my name's Stuart. You've been watching Thumb Culture. And these guys are going to be dead-ish, maybe. Take it easy.